Susie Elelman is a lovely regular addition to our panel here at Studio 10, and as part of that has been very open about her love life or lack of it. So imagine Susie's delight recently when she was asked out by a sailor, musician and part-time model who'd seen Susie on our show. Now, after exchanging emails, 47-year-old Craig Lemke went out to lunch with Susie and things might have developed further. Well, they certainly did. He was arrested for his alleged involvement in a $245 million cocaine importation scheme. Lemke is accused of arranging the importation of the yacht that was used to smuggle in 700 kilos of cocaine. He was refused bail in a Newcastle court. So has this experience caused Susie to give up on men? And she joins us now. Susie, good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Obviously, this arrest was a huge shock for you.
Oh, was it ever? Talk about being knocked over by a feather. I actually do the whole story in Woman's Day this week, but very briefly, I had absolutely no idea. I was blindsided. I was watching telly, would you believe, getting ready to go to a movie and heard it announced on the news. And I was actually getting ready, so I didn't even look at the screen until I heard his name and then looked up to see this full screen. I've got a 65-centimetre TV and his face was plastered across the whole thing. Had no idea.
He's a very handsome-looking guy.
Isn't he? That, I think that's one of my problems, Ita.
I think looking for love always has an element of risk to it, doesn't it?
Without a doubt. I think when we meet someone, most times they're strangers, and we all put our best foot forward. So it isn't until you sort of get to know somebody a bit more that you realise whether they're suitable or not.
But he knew a lot about you because you're on telly.
Exactly.
You didn't know a lot about him.
Not at all. Only by the things that he told me about himself.
Well, we were talking, but you and I were talking about love and being an older woman the other day. I mean, if you're a strong older woman, I mean, how do you find love?
I wish I knew, but I think there's two key things in that. Strong, as in most men, or a lot of men, say, use the big I word. You know, they're intimidated by a strong woman, so that has its problems. But older woman too, because most blokes that I want to date that are my age are dating women half my age.
Yeah, they want a chick.
Exactly, a young chick.
Now, for you, Susie, I don't think it's just an issue for more mature women. I think women in their 30s and 40s who have divorced or separated, it's a big issue for them to find the right person. You know, you used to be social groups or tennis groups. Are you now very wary of internet dating? Would that be a big thing for you?
Oh, big. I've always been wary of internet dating, Tash. And I'd done a lot of it before sort of giving up. Because, again, people aren't necessarily what they say they are online. And I've probably got enough stories to write a book about my online dating experience. You know, looking at photos online and then you meet up with them and you kind of go, whose photo were you using online or how long ago was it taken? That sort of thing.
I remember reading a story once in a newspaper recently where this woman started dating this guy and they were very, very much in love, and then she actually found out he was living a completely double life and he was a, you know, terrible liar. Did you see any warning signs with this situation?
Not at all. And in his defence, he was very charming, very caring, really was great to me, you know, very supportive. I was going through a couple of traumatic things at the time and he couldn't have been more friendly and more helpful.
Are you shattered?
I think probably shattered is a good word, because I had been through a long-term relationship many years ago that had really left me thinking, I can't trust men ever again. And then you sort of go along and you think, you meet people and you date them and nothing ever eventuates. And then out of the blue, he came along, good looking, as you say, and talented musician and all of that. And I think, oh, maybe there could be. And then whammo, this kind of, the rug gets pulled out from underneath you.
So is this it? You're off men? Or do you think if the right guy comes along, maybe, perhaps?
I'm the eternal optimist.
Aww.
And I would really love to think that there is someone out there, but I'm also a pragmatist. And that part of me says, look, you know, because I gave up ages ago. So when Craig came on the scene, it was such a surprise and so lovely that now I think, well, No, I just give up.
Susie, there's a great quote saying it is better to have loved than to have never loved at all. What would your advice be in hindsight? Would you do anything differently? Or if there are women out there looking, what advice would you give them?
I think just don't be taken in. You know, sort of be, make sure that you cover your bases as well. Certainly don't let it make you too negative towards mm-hmm. men, because I think it's hard enough anyway. I mm-hmm. think in this world, with women being so strong, and not just older women, that men feel they don't quite know what they can do and what they can't do.
But you want to trust them, don't you?
You do.
Absolutely. I mean, love is wonderful. And you want that buzz in your life.
Absolutely. And I think the key word there is trust. Mm-hmm. And I think you have to earn that trust. And so if you do put up too many walls, then people won't have an opportunity to be trusted. But by the same token, you don't want to feel vulnerable either. So there's that kind of fine line.
Just remember the song, Love is Lovelier for the second.
Second, third
fourth, fifth, seventh time around, whatever.
The interesting thing about all of this is that I've copped the most amount of criticism.
Have because, you?
Yes,
Why?
Because he was so much younger than me. Mm. So, I mean, whereas if you were to reverse it, if you were to put a 47-year-old woman with a 63-year-old man, no one would have...
No one questions it.
...batted an eyelid. But I've the one that copped it.
Oh, so Susie, going,
oh,
we
should
love
have
you
known
though.
Better.
Thank you so much for joining us this
yes.
morning. It's
young at heart.
Thanks for sharing.
Thanks for having
Susie
me.
Susie Elelman, thank you.